Sige, start na tayo. So sa video natin ngayon, let's try to solve the support reactions of this truss using Verdun's theorem. And also, merong dalawang methods akong ituturo ngayon. Yung isa medyo mahaba but flexible for kahit anong loading dyan. And then yung isa naman is applicable for symmetrical loadings for forces na equidistant from the extremes. Yan. So, for the first method, by the way, meron na palang sagot. This is from Hibbler's book. Ito, meron ng reactions dyan. Ito, 1159.3 saka ito. Then, AX naman is equal to 0. So, paano yan siya kunin? Now, diba, the first, ano tawag dito? Yung first na ginagawa ng students is ito. Hinahanap nila yung components ng forces natin. So, we have this external force. So, ginagawa nilang ganito. Yan. Merong components, diba, na to the right and then acting downward. And then, ito naman, to the left and acting downward. But notice na masyadong mahaba yung solution pag ganito yung orientation ng forces mo. So, instead, gagawin natin, let's say, yung first kong gustong kunin is IY. Ito, so, sabihin natin, IY. Yan. Now, diba, to get this reaction, then I have to take moments about point A so that I can eliminate AY. So, summation tayo ng moments about A. And then, let's try to find another way instead of resolving this into components. Kasi, again, masyado nang mahaba. Di na yan magkakasya sa calculator natin. So, ito yung approach dyan. By the way, itong forces natin come from wind loads. So, lahat ng yan perpendicular to the member. Bala, ito, this forms a 90 degree angle. Yan lahat. So, ito yung gagawin natin. For these loads, diba, magmo-moment tayo sa point A, these loads are already perpendicular sa ano natin, sa point A. So, yung gagawin na lang natin is to find the resultant of these forces. Itong 300 pound force, ito, saka ito. Isasali na lang din natin to para ma-appreciate na talaga yung Vernion's theorem. So, diba, itong lahat ng forces, meron siyang resultant force. Let's say, located dito. Assumption ko lang yan. And then, the resultant of these forces, kasi parallel kasi yung lahat ng forces na yan, it must be the sum of all forces. So, sabihin natin R. R is equal to 150 plus tatlong 300. So, 3 times 300. Ayan. So, ano yan? Diba? 1,050. So, meron tayong resultant na 1,050 pounds. And then next, hahanapin natin yung perpendicular distance niya going to point A. Ito. Sabihin natin, D. Yan. Now first, to get the resultant of parallel force systems, diba, kailangan natin yung distances na to. This one, and the rest. Now since 3 feet yung spacing natin dito, these distances are equal. Ito, equal yan sa distance na to, saka ito. So, sabihin na lang natin na this is a distance A. Now, paano natin kukunin yung distance na yan? Diba, we can consider this triangle. Yan. Alam natin na 30 degrees yung inclination niya from the horizontal. So, we can use the cosine function kasi itong side na to, diba, that's adjacent to our reference angle. So, cosine 30 pala, is equal to the adjacent side 3 divided by the hypotenuse. Sabihin natin sa label natin A. Yan. So cos 30 ano na lang A is equal to 3 divided by cos 30. So 2 square root of 3 pala. Or 3.46. Now, para mas madali, I will just store this sa letter A. Kasi A yung naka-indicate dyan. So, shift, store, A. Ayan. And then, to get D, this distance, let's apply Vergnon's theorem. So, diba, the moment caused by the resultant force is equal to the individual moments or the sum of individual moments of the components. So, 1050 multiplied by D equal yan to itong force na to, wala siyang moment arm going to this point. So, it will be eliminated. But itong 300-pound force, meron siyang moment arm na A. Yan. So, 300 multiplied by A. Now, diba, if this is A, itong distance na to also A din yan. And also this one. Yan. So, i-ano ko na lang, I will just factor out 300, and then, for the first force, 300 times A, then sa second, 300 times 2A, so, ipa-plus ko na lang, plus 2A, then for this force, tatlong A, A plus A plus A, so, 3A. Ayan. And then, isosolve natin yung distance D. So, 1050 multiplied by D equals 300. And then, diba, pwede natin i-join lahat ng coefficients ng A. 3 plus 2 plus 1 magiging 6. So, 300 times 6A na lang. Ayan. So, solving D, we have 5.938. So, shift, store, lalagay ko sa D. Ayan. So, alam ko na yung distance na to. So, I can just use the resultant force and this perpendicular distance in taking moments about A. So, ito yung mayayari. Equal yan to 0 dapat. So, I have 1050 multiplied by this perpendicular distance. So, nakastore yan sa letter D. Capital D na lang. Yan. And then, we have this force, 500-pound force. So, plus natin, 500. Perpendicular distance niya going to point A is ito. So, 3 times 4, that will give us 12. Yan. Na ito yung medyo mahirap, yung forces dito. Kasi kahit meron kang resultant force, wala ka kasing perpendicular distance going to point A. Kasi for example, diba, meron kang resultant dyan. You still have to extend this and then kailangan mong kunin yung perpendicular distance na to. Yan. So medyo mahirap pag kunin natin yan siya using purely geometry. So, yung gagawin na lang natin is we have to resolve this into components talaga. Itong forces dito. So, first, let's analyze kung ano yung inclination ng forces na to with respect to the horizontal. So, again, all of these forces are acting perpendicular to the member kasi galing yan sa wind loads. So, pwede ko yung i-draw. Ito. So, this is 30 degrees. Ayan. And then, let's try to draw a perpendicular line. This one. So, ito yung force natin, perpendicular to the surface. So, we can draw from here, we can draw across. Ayan. Now, di ba, alam natin na this is perpendicular. So, dapat 90 degrees yung total niya. Now, if this is 30 degrees from the horizontal, then this must also be 30 degrees, di ba? And then, if this is 30 degrees, ano yung angle na to? This angle would be 60 degrees. Kasi 60 plus 30 equals 90. And then, itong angle na to is 90 degrees. So, with respect to the horizontal pala, lahat ng inclinations ng forces natin are 60 degrees. So, eto, 60. Basically, lahat ng yan. Isusulat ko na lang. Yan. So, alam na natin yung angles. Pwede na natin siyang i-resolve into components. So, since meron akong angle with respect to the horizontal, then yung with respect to y must be 300 sine 60, and then with respect to x, or along x, the component along x is 300 cosine 60. So, sulat ko na lang din. 300 sine 60 yan lahat. Wait lang. Saka, ito pala, 150 lang. Kasi 150 yung load natin. Then, sine 60. And then, lahat ng horizontal forces naman would be 300 cosine 60. Ito rin. Ito, saka, yung last naman is 150 cosine 60. Ayan. So, di ba, lahat ng forces na vertical components na to, this one, and this one, equal yung magnitude. So, pwede ko siyang i-factor out, and then, yung 300 sine 60, it will cause a clockwise rotation about point A. So, I have to use plus. By the way, yung assumption ko is positive yung clockwise moments. We have to make this clear. So, 300 sine 60, yan, for this force, we have a moment arm going to point A, diba, 12 man yan, 12. So, 12 plus 3, that will give us 15. And then, for this component, moment arm niya is plus another 3, so 15 plus 3 magiging 18. And then for this one naman, ito, moment arm niya is this one. So, 18 plus another 3, magiging 21. And then for 150 sine 60, yung buong distance na yan, so 24. So, plus 150 sine 60 times 24. Ayan. And then, dito naman tayo sa horizontal forces. Now, for the horizontal forces, hindi ito kasali. Yung 150 cosine 60, yung line of action niya tatama sa point A. So, wala siyang moment na makukos. Only itong 300 cosine 60, yung tatlo na yan. So, mangyayari, it will cause a, ito yung mangyayari, hawakan natin yan, and then apply tayo ng force to the left, the rotation will be counterclockwise. So, I have to use minus. Yan. And then, 300 cosine 60. Now, ano yung moment arms natin? Pwede natin itong i-factor out, but we still have to know these distances. Ito, ito, saka ito. Kasi yan yung perpendicular distance ng horizontal component ng force natin. So, to do that, let's say, itong distance na to is letter C. So, paano yan isolve? Diba, alam natin yung angle na to, 30 degrees yan. So, we can use the tangent function. Kasi gusto natin yung opposite side to the reference angle. So, tangent of 30 degrees equals C opposite divided by adjacent, which is 3. Yan. So, solving C, tangent, 3 tangent 30. So, press equals, we have square root of 3. So, shift, store, lalagay ko sa C. Now, if this is C, then this distance must be 2C. And then, ito naman, 3C. Kasi, diba, 3 feet yan, ito, 6 feet, so, magta times 2 yung vertical distance niya. So, for my moment arms pala, I can just use, for this load, moment arm niya is 3C. Then, for this load naman, 2C. So, 3C plus 2C. And then, for this load, yung component na yan, we have a distance C. So, plus C. So, nasulat na natin lahat ng forces. Meron pa palang kulang for a while, ah. Nasali ko pala to. Sorry. Dito yan dapat. Ayan. Ito kasi yung kanina sa resultant natin. And then, yung moment ng IY, this force, clockwise about this point. Kasi pag ito yung hawakan natin, and then apply natin yung force na to, rotation is counterclockwise. So, minus IY, ayan, minus IY multiplied by 24. So, set natin yan to 0. So, input natin lahat sa calculators natin. We have 1050 multiplied by D. Yan. Then, plus 500 times 12 plus eto, 300 sine 60. Then, times 15 plus 18 plus 21. Then, plus 150 sine 60 multiplied by 24, then minus 300 cosine 60 multiplied by 3c plus 2c plus c. Pwede natin i-add lahat ng coefficients, magiging 6c. Then, minus iy times 24. Ayan, set natin to 0. So, solving IY, we have 1159.3266.74. So, screenshot ko na lang. So, ito yung value ng IY. Now, bakit ko to tinuro if merong mas madaling way? Itong method kasi na to, this is applicable if the loads are not symmetrical. But kung mapapansin nyo, lahat ng loads from the extremes, equidistant from the extremes are equal, diba? Kasi this is 150. This is also 150. And then lahat ng forces na yan, 300. Lahat ng forces din dito are 300. And then itong 500 pound force applied directly at the center. So, since symmetrical yung loading natin, then we can just actually add all of the horizontal, all of the vertical forces, then divide na lang natin by 2. Yan na yung reaction sa I saka A. Kasi diba equal lang yung reactions nila. Yan. So, yung alternative approach natin would just be to sum up all vertical forces, then divide it by 2. So, ito yung mayayari. We have AY, then equal yan to IY. So, this is simply the summation of all vertical forces. So, madali lang kasi we have 150, di ba? 150 sine 60 for this one. Then, meron tayong tatlong 300 pound force. So, plus 3 times 300, then sine 60. Yan. So, makukuha na natin lahat ng vertical components ng forces na to. Now, since merong dalawang sides containing the same forces, same magnitude, then I can just multiply this by 2. So, multiply ko yan by 2. Then, i-add natin yung force dito sa gitna, which is 500. So, plus 500, and then divide ko na lang yan by 2. So, makukuha ko na yung same value kanina. Ito, 1159. Try down natin. 2 times 150 sine 60, then plus 300, I mean, ano pala, 3 times 300 sine 60, then plus 500, divide natin by 2. So press equals, as you can notice, the same lang. By the way, yung unit is pounds pala. Yan. Now, kung napapansin nyo, medyo maikli lang yung solution natin dito. But take note na this is only applicable if symmetrical yung loadings natin sa left side saka right side. Bale, hindi yan, hindi natin to ma-apply na method if, for example, this is 400 and then this is, sabihin natin, 700. Hindi na yan applicable kasi hindi na symmetrical yung loadings. Kailangan na talaga na ito yung approach if the loadings are not symmetrical. Kaya tinuro ko yan. But since sa board exam or sa in most cases talaga sa trusses, ito yung loadings kasi yung loads dyan are from tributary areas galing sa wind loads. So, mas maganda pag alam mo yung alternative method. Ito. Kapag symmetrical lang yung loading. So, pag meron kayong mga tanong, try to comment lang. About this problem lang. Muna. Chacha ko lang yung chat ah. Baka may ibang problems pa. Discord. Ah, sige. Recap daw sa unang method. For the first method, nag-component talaga tayo sa side na to. Itong nasa right side. But yung Verignon's theorem, ginamit natin for this side. Kasi, nag-moment tayo sa point A. Itong point na to. Diba, dyan tayo nag-moment. Yan, summation of moments about A. Ibig sabihin, I can just get the resultant of these forces instead of getting their components. Kasi pag nag-component tayo, masyadong mahaba na. So, kinuha ko na lang yung component niya, kinuha ko yung distance niya from here. I mean, from point A. So, again, yung Vernon's theorem, kung ano yung moment na makukos ng resultant, equal yan sa total moments na makukos ng components. So, same lang yan sa parallel force systems natin. Yung discussion natin last time. So, wait lang. Saan ba yan? Eto. Yan. So, the same lang yan dito. Na-post ko na pala to. I think, last week or last week. Now, parallel force system kasi to. Eto. Lahat ng forces dyan, parallel. So, pwede natin kunin yung resultant. Saka, location niya. From a certain reference axis of rotation. Okay lang ba? Anyway, itong video na to, this is, pwede nyo ma-replay. And then, ipopost ko din to sa YouTube afterwards. Pag meron na akong time. Maybe next time, ito namang zero force members naman yung i-discuss natin. Yung letter, ano? Yung naka-store for a while ah. Yung C dyan saka A, yan yung distances. Masyadong mahaba na kasi pag isusulat ko. So, itong A 3.46, yan yung distance niyan. Bala 3.46. Yan. And then nakuha yan using the cosine function. Kasi cosine 30, di ba, adjacent divided by hypotenuse, we are considering this triangle. Yan. So, cosine 30, adjacent side is 3 feet, and then the hypotenuse is this one, which is indicated as A sa problem natin. So, A equals 3.46. Yan. And then yung C naman, that's using the tangent function. Eto. Tangent 30 equals opposite divided by adjacent. So yung value ng C is actually 1.73. So this is 1.73 meters. Ito naman, magdodoble kasi 6 meters na yung adjacent side. So, kaya naging 2C. Ito naman naging 3C. Kailangan nyo kasing masanay talaga, lalo na sa structural theory, yung storing of values para mas madali yung solutions nyo. So, itong trust na to, lumabas to sa time namin, sa board exam talaga, but walang forces dito. Only sa left side. So, medyo madali lang. Mas mahirap lang talaga yung nasa books natin.